Hello and welcome to Her Essence. It's me, Soni Masharia.
And me, Shiku Mwangi.
So today, first of all, thank you so much for joining us for our first episode. Thank you so much for the feedback. We hope that you join us through this journey. As friends, let's have this conversation, right?
Yeah.
Today, we are going to talk about identity. Mm-hmm. So, what is identity?
Ah, wow. Let's start by defining identity. So, identity, what is identity? Of course, there are so many definitions out there. And one that I'd like us to use for the purpose of this show today is that identity is who you are. Identity is what image you portrayed to the world and to the people that and the community that you interact with. Identity is the things that you do, like, you know, your purpose, what is your character, this is your identity. And identity starts from something as simple as your name.
Exactly.
I am Shiko, you're Sonny, there's John. That is your identity.
I feel like identity is intrinsic in us.
It is.
It's like natural for us, but until we find it, then it's going to be hard to maneuver life without knowing, accept. If you don't settle for something, if you don't believe for something, people are going to make, you're going to believe in anything. Right?
If you don't have a certain route you want to follow,
any road will be fine. You'll be like, okay, I'm fine, let's go.
Yeah.
Okay, so identity, I feel like the purpose to find our identity is to live by us and to know what your purpose in life, what you're meant to do, right? Because if your identity is defined by others, then you're gonna have to live fulfilling what they want about you. Like you will live a life for them, not for yourself,
right? And you won't even feel fulfilled. I feel like you'd be very confused in this journey of life. And you know, especially like from your teens, because that's around the age where you start identifying yourself and you start realizing, oh wow, this is what I like. I don't like doing ABCD. Like these are my preferences. And from that age till, you know, it's a journey.
Yeah.
And you just keep identifying, I like this, I don't like this. I like doing this like this, I don't like doing them like this. And the problem is, one problem that I'm pretty sure you have also noticed, and even some of your viewers, I'm pretty sure you have also noticed this and realized it, even maybe with yourself, is growing up, we allow our experiences, we allow other people's opinions of us, we allow the things that have been done to us to identify us. We have our flaws and our mistakes. We allow them to be our identity.
Yeah.
In which I think, Son, that should not be the case. Yeah. I feel like the mistakes you did, the experiences you had, they should not define you at all. Exactly.
Yeah. You should find a space where you feel like, for me, I can be Son without you influencing her. Because I read somewhere actually, identity is affirmed and reaffirmed by only God and nobody else.
Yes.
Once you let people come in, and I'll tell you, okay, now you have to do this.
Like this,
you can't do this, you're awful at that,
then
that's where enemies come in, because enemies like why you don't know who you are. That's like a gap. They
it's
feel like
a footstool for them,
that they have to, like, now let's see what we can do to mess you up,
exactly.
Because you don't know who you are, and then you underestimate your power.
I like what you're saying here. It's easier for enemies to attack you when you're divided inside you.
Exactly,
you know, when you do not even have confidence in who you are, you don't have confidence in your abilities, in yourself. You know, the problem with not knowing your identity is, today you meet a certain lady and she likes her hair long, she likes her hair retouched, short, she likes her hair with a fro like mine. She doesn't do her nails, this other one likes heels, you're going to flow with it.
Yeah.
You like purple, so do I. You like, so do I. But knowing yourself and being firm, it's very hard for you to be influenced. Especially influenced wrongly, you know. Unapata watu wenye, you're not even confident in your own skin.
Yeah.
And even now, because we have already said that identity comes from God. And now that you need that confidence in yourself, because you know, I am a daughter of God.
Yes,
you know,
you are
a daughter of God. You should live in that confidence. With this confidence, the enemy will not come for you.
Confidence scares enemies away.
Yes.
And then I was thinking of what identity can do to you, right? Mm-hmm. When you have identity, you have set a purpose for your life,
yes.
And you have realized what you want, mm-hmm. and what, now you have set parameters.
Yes.
There are things I can't tolerate,
oh,
right?
Yes.
For people,
mm-hmm.
as long as you have that, it's, let's call it principles,
mm-hmm.
of
standards.
What people can't do to you.
Yes.
Then that's your power. I feel like
true.
Confidence is just this sassiness surrounding us.
True.
Once your confidence,
and it's such
you
a beautiful
rule.
Thing in a woman,
yeah.
finding a lady who is confident in who they are. You know, there's nothing that can
phase
you. Nothing. I mean, you're confident, you're a daughter of a king. Hallelujah.
Yes.
You know that, you know what? This is my gift. These are my gifts. This is my purpose. This is who I am created to be. You are comfortable in that, and you know, I am undefeated because I have Christ in me, and I can do all things through Christ in me, right?
Yeah.
And that is really, I don't know, I feel empowered even just by talking about
yeah,
it right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. And then most of the people, you allow people who
yeah.
do not realize who they are themselves,
mm.
identify you.
Oh, yes.
Because if you don't know Shiko,
mm-hmm.
you don't know who you are,
yeah.
but you attack who you think I am,
mm.
then you should. I shouldn't accept you.
Yes.
to dictate what I should do, because
sure.
I say, you remember the analogy I gave you of water, right?
Mm-hmm.
This, like a glass of water full, it, that's your identity filled in by God.
Yes.
When anyone says things, let's just illustrate like a ball, people place balls on your identity, it's never gonna sink. It's
mm-hmm.
always gonna float.
Yes.
Because that water is, the water now in the analogy, is God.
Yes.
Your identity filled by God.
Yes.
You should never
so
allow
people's
anyone.
Opinions,
yes.
whatever the society has said and done to you,
should
just
this.
Float. Will just come to a full cup.
Yeah.
And we should not let these things get to our head and get to our heart, especially we even be asked by the Bible to guard our hearts, for from it flows the wellsprings of life. So I like what you're saying. Be filled. Being so filled with God that whatever the society brings at you,
yeah.
you're winning.
You're a diamond,
yeah.
honey. They
mm-hmm.
don't break you.
Exactly.
They cannot.
I like that.
That's identity is just, you know how I think, I presume diamonds are put like somewhere, preserved. They are rocks.
Yes.
That's who we are. And you realizing your defaults, your identity, that is
yes.
your pros, your cons,
mm-hmm.
your what you can do, what you
yeah.
can't do,
mm-hmm.
that is you building your wall.
Yes.
Right? You strengthening your diamond.
Mm-hmm.
They cannot break
it. And they cannot break it.
Yes.
They cannot break it.
Yes.
I mean, you have God in you.
But
that is
you
unbreakable.
Yeah,
that is
so
unbreakable.
He should be the only one
mm-hmm.
who indicates who you should be.
Yes.
Right? It
yes.
should be informed by him,
mm-hmm.
not any other person. Nobody should come and say, okay, son, I think you should do this different.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't know themselves.
Yeah.
You shouldn't allow you to such
true.
People in life,
because people even attacking you, in most cases they attack you from points of weakness.
Yeah,
it's a bruised ego, it's someone who has insecurities,
yeah.
and so they are just channeling it to you, and you who is not confident in yourself, you who is not confident in God's identity of you. I mean, God created you, and so he knows you.
Yeah.
People who make machines and equipment, they know
yeah.
how they should be used, they know the purpose of these machines and equipment. But the same thing for us, God has created us beautifully and wonderfully made. Can you just take a moment and let that sink in?
The same thing you were talking about machines, I thought
mm-hmm.
about it like this.
Mm-hmm.
You see, when your car destroys and you need to go see a mechanic,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
When you run out, you know where to run.
Where to
it
run
will
to
never
that.
Run out. It will never, in a minute. When you ask for something, means
mm-hmm.
you know he has it.
Yes.
It's like an act of faith.
Yes.
And then you're talking about enemies. Something that scares enemies away is just a firm confidence,
yes.
lady.
Yes.
They cannot
at
all.
They cannot defeat you. They'll fight you.
Yeah.
But the weapons fashioned against you will definitely not prosper.
Yeah.
I like this. I don't know if it's a quote or a meme that goes like, you stand stronger when you stand on your knees.
Oh, no? Yeah.
Yes?
Yes.
So you start your day on your knees, you start your day with God, and he will give you the strength to go through that day, whatever comes your way. Amen. You're going to come back in the evening and you're going to be giving thanks because you will have conquered whatever it is that was
yeah.
coming at you.
Then identity, once you have realized identity,
yeah.
you attract who you are.
True, true,
you
true.
Attract people in your life
yes.
who are like you. you will never settle for mediocrity.
Mm-hmm.
You never settle for people who just want to attack you. You will never,
who are against
in a minute,
bias.
Yeah, or people who do not, who go past your parameters, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
We say you have a parameter because you have realized
yeah.
who you are
mm-hmm.
and what you can do.
Yes.
And you have realized your power. I feel like the power, after you realize your power, then mm-hmm. nobody else. We just said we are superheroes, man.
Yes.
We are superheroes. And nobody gonna come up past. You're like your, Superman, right?
Yes.
Like, I can't. I feel
Wonder
like this
Woman,
is speaking
baby.
To me. So this, mm-hmm. You have like a shield of confidence, mm-hmm. a little bit sus over there, you know mm-hmm. who you are,
mm-hmm.
you have God covered.
Yes.
Then who's gonna come for
Nobody
you?
Nobody's gonna come for you. They will come for you, that's the thing. They will come for you, but they will not win.
They will never.
Because, you know, an enemy is not necessarily fellow human beings.
Yeah.
It's that even discouragement. It's just that's starting to doubt your potential, because maybe you're doing something, maybe it's a project, or maybe it's even in school or at work, or whatever it is that you do, and you start doubting your ability, and you start doubting your, you know, you just start doubting your potential, and maybe this is a gift that you've been given, just start doubting
yeah.
it. And that's why it's very important to go back, always go back to your creator, always go back to him, because he will remind you. We have verses in the Bible, and he will just keep reminding you of who you are. You are the daughter of a king.
Yes,
you know, you are his daughter. He loves you for who you are. He created you for a great, great purpose.
Yeah, and then after you have realized who you are,
mm-hmm.
you will never feel the need of validation.
Yes.
We often feel as women that mm-hmm. we need to be validated,
mm-hmm.
to be like, okay, now I do feel it.
Yes.
You will never feel that, because you know who you are.
Mm-hmm.
You know whose daughter you are.
Yeah.
You know what you stand for. So you know, you will never
mm-hmm.
need somebody's validation to let you.
So that you can, like, you know, just get back to,
yeah.
oh yeah, I actually forgot, but now that you
no.
said it, no, no.
When it runs out, we know where
mm-hmm.
to go.
Exactly.
Yeah. So I feel identity is a very, sometimes we think it's a minor issue,
mm.
but identity is the start of who you are.
True.
It's the start of you growing to the next step.
The start
if
of
you
your
don't,
essence.
Yeah. Your ultimate nature.
Yes.
I like
mm-hmm.
that.
Because mm-hmm.
now identity, you know, like we were talking about essence being the ultimate nature.
Yes.
As opposed to what people believe you are.
Mm.
As long as you know that.
Yes.
Then you live your essence, honey. You will always stand out.
Yes.
Because you will never be a pick-me-up.
Mm-hmm.
You will never be a pick-me-up.
You will be so strong. And that is going to help us, even as women, to stand with each other. You know,
yeah.
if two of you have identified yourselves, and two of you have found your essence, and you know that this is who we are, you're confident in it, you're able to support other women,
yeah.
you're able to really build each other up and just get
grow
to
together,
yes,
fix
yes,
each
yes.
other's crowns
exactly.
as queens we are, right?
Yes.
So I think that's what we wanted to talk about today.
Yeah.
So as soon as you sit down with yourself, call yourself the me meetings we do,
mm-hmm.
and identify who are you. Who are you, son?
Yeah.
What do you stand yes. for? What do you tolerate? What mm-hmm. can you, you know,
not tolerate?
Like, yes.
Yes.
As soon as you realize your power, it's over.
Mm.
It's over for your enemies. It scares them away.
Yes. Yes. And that is your strength. That is your strength.
That is your strength,
strength
yes. as a woman. Never, you will never count on validation. You will never expect people to say things, because you know you're awesome.
Mm-hmm.
You know you're perfect. With all your imperfections, you whether you're broken, you know you're broken and you're beautiful. You don't need no
exactly.
one to tell you shit.
Exactly.
So, that was it for today.
Yeah. And just a sneak peek, today we've touched on identity, and we said that you are a daughter of God.
Yeah.
Do not forget that. Join us next week as we talk more on God's concern with our daily lives as his precious daughter.
Thank you so much for joining us. It's been me, Soni Masharia.
And me, Shiku Mwangi. And that was Her Essence on Wema Online TV on Facebook and YouTube. Be sure to follow us.
Wema TV, the voice of hope.